Tonight, the president is talking education, merit pay for teachers.
The relative decline of American education is untenable for our economy. It's unsustainable for our democracy. It's unacceptable for our children. We can't afford to let it continue.
What's the reaction from the teachers' union? Speaking of unions, the Employee Free Choice Act. The push is on, and the unions want all Democrats on board. Are they? We'll visit with Leo Gerard, president of the United Steelworkers International. And what about health care? With premiums going up for all Americans, I gave my bill to Senate Majority Leader Harry Reid. The Senate leader says he's ready to go antitrust on insurance companies.
I have sponsored legislation to take away their exemption. Why should they be treated any different than anyone else?
Is the president going to support you on that?
I would hope so.
And what is the president's plan on health care? John Podesta responds. All tonight on 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue.
We will start by doing a little housekeeping.
Day 50 of the Obama administration. Good evening, everybody. I'm Ed Schultz in for David Schuster tonight. Now, my real job is I'm a radio talk show host based here in Washington, D.C. And, you know, I've always said if you're going to be a good talker, you got to be a good listener. Now, on the Ed Schultz Show around America, we have been able to do a lot of town hall meetings. In fact, we have done 12 town hall meetings in the last 6 months. Folks, you know what they're talking about out there across America? Healthcare. 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 In fact, I brought my health care bill to Washington. Now, this is what Americans are putting up with. It's the economy, it's jobs, but on your kitchen table, I'm getting the same thing, an increase of 20%. Now, here are the numbers. Last year, my wife and I spent $781.40 a month, okay? That's an annual cost of $9,376.80. Now I get the candy gram in the mail. This year, 2009, oh, I get to spend $936 a month for an annual cost of $11,242.44 a year. Now, folks, this is $155.47 a month increase. This is $1,865. Who's got $2,000 laying around the table? I thought this was supposed to be about the middle class. I thought this was supposed to be about helping workers across America. Where is the stimulus package? So I took my bill, I went to Capitol Hill, and had a conversation with Senate Majority Leader Harry Reid.
We spend 40% more money on health care in this country than any other industrialized nation. We're 29th in life expectancy, 42nd in infant mortality. Now the Democrats have the White House, the House, and the Senate. What do you do to turn those numbers around?
Well, I've had people come to me and say, with the economic condition of our country, how can you afford to do health care? My response is, how can we afford not to do health care? We have almost 50 million Americans with no health insurance. We have millions of others who are underinsured. But you know, those 50 million plus people, if they get sick or injured, they go to their family physician. An emergency room, the closest emergency room they can go to. The most expensive care in America is an emergency room. Because of that, our insurance premiums are high, our hospital and doctor bills are higher than they should be, indigent taxes are high, so we cannot afford to go on longer without health care reform. We are not getting our money's worth, and it is time the American people had health insurance like we have in most other industrialized nations.
Folks, here's the disconnect. Those are my numbers. Now let's go to the front office and let me show you some real numbers. It's not only happening on Wall Street. It's happening all across America with executive pay. Now let's go to the front office of the Michigan Blue Cross Blue Shield Department. And you know what you're going to find? You're going to find, look at this, Dan Loeb. I mean, this dude, back in 2006, he had a salary of $990,000. Apparently, he couldn't get it done on that number. But 24 months later, he was good for $1.8 million. After firing 1,000 employees, after your health care in Michigan going up by double digits. It doesn't stop there. How about the Blue Cross CFO, Mark Bartlett? 2006, he couldn't make it on $975,000 a year, so they had to bump him up to almost $1.25 million. And it doesn't stop there. It's just not in Michigan where it's been tough economy. Let's go to North Dakota Blue Cross and Blue Shield CEO Mike Unjum, who, by the way, was fired today because they are losing the trust and confidence of the people. His salary, $412,000 just 24 months ago. Well, today, when he left his job, he was making $664,431. Now, I want to know. Do you want to know? What is Harry Reid and the Congress going to do about this? So I asked him.
Would you be willing to see legislation that would reel in the insurance industry?
The insurance industry is the only business in America that's exempt from the Sherman Antitrust Act except baseball. Every other company, if people who own TV stations got together to try to fix prices, civil and criminal penalties. People that manufacture shoes, shirts, glasses, doesn't matter who it is, doctors, if they sat down and talked about how to set same prices, they're subject to criminal and civil penalties, but not the good old insurance industry.
Well, I should point out that the executives of the insurance company that Wendy and I buy from, the CEO took a 62% increase in pay over the last 24 months, and all of the other executives did at least a 40% increase. So are you in favor of antitrust laws going into insurance?
I have sponsored legislation to take away their exemption. Why should they be treated any different than anyone else?
Is the president going to support you on that?
I would hope so.
Folks, who's going to pay for this? I mean, how are we going to pay for this? And the conservatives are over there saying, well, we can't raise taxes. What else are you going to do? We have got to find a revenue stream to make this happen. But insurance companies in this country, I think, have got a moral obligation to back off. People are losing their jobs. They're absorbing double-digit increases across the board in their premiums. And you boys in the front office are sticking it to us with million-dollar increases? That's crazy. That's crazy. Now, talking about how you're going to pay for this thing, well, you got to get out of Iraq. Senator Reid, what about that?
And, Senator, what about the comment that the president is going to pull 12,000 troops out of Iraq by September? Are you comfortable with that number? Is that enough?
Hey, I've said for more than 2 years, let the Iraqis handle their own situation.
But is that enough troops to get out? Is that fast enough for you?
Well, fast enough for me is one thing. I'm going to support the president. He's come up with an Iraq policy that he says about 15 months we'll be down to 35 to 50,000. I can accept that.
35 to 50,000? That's a little bit different from what we heard from Senator Reid not long ago. He was questioning the president's numbers. Now he's on board. But just remember one thing, taxpayers. 35 to 50,000 troops in Iraq means about $4 billion a month. Honestly, did you vote for that? We got to push hard if we really want to get out of Iraq. So then we shifted gears in the interview. Let's go to Wall Street. Senator Reid telling me he is not going to let Citigroup fail.
First, the banks. How far are you willing to go to help Citigroup and other financial?
How do the people of America feel? More than 10% of every bank deposit in America is held by Citigroup. Are we going to let them fail? I don't think so.
So you're not going to let them fail?
If I have anything to do with it, I'm not going to. These are not gifts to these companies. We're taking an interest in these companies. These banks are going to start doing better that we've given money to. And when they do, we'll get some of the benefit from that, we the taxpayers.
So you will not let Citigroup fail?
I'm going to work with the president and try to do everything I can to make sure that it doesn't fail.
More from my interview with Senator Reid. That's still to come on 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue. But up next, President Obama got elected with the help of organized labor. Now, will Democrats and the Obama administration back a new bill making it easier for unions to organize workers? We'll get the view from the president of the United Steelworkers International. And later, overhauling the U.S. health care system. Can the Obama administration get Congress to buy into the president's multi-billion-dollar plan by tying it to the economy? The answer from the co-chairman of the Obama-Biden transition team, John Podesta. You're watching 1600.